Hi, this is Jithin from HighLevel Techie. So today I'm going to talk to you about how you can become a Go HighLevel certified admin in your first Go itself. So when I look at this issue, I can see there are mainly two reasons why people fail in the exam. One is they don't have enough time, or the second is they don't have enough practice. Well, you can also consider a third reason, which is they overestimate their skills in Go HighLevel. So here the basic working assumption is that you have enough experience with Go HighLevel, you are working on Go HighLevel for some time, and you are a mini expert in Go HighLevel. So keeping these as the assumptions, I'm going to go ahead and explain to you how you can clear this exam. As you might know, there are two sections for this exam, Part A exam and Part B exam. So if you have been working on Go HighLevel for long enough, you can definitely clear the Part A exam. So Part A exam is basically you go through a long list of videos for each of the feature in Go HighLevel, and then you answer a quiz. So when you watch all the videos and finish all the quiz associated with that videos, and you get 100% pass in all the sections, you can unlock Part A exam, which is a long list of quiz again, multiple choice quiz. And there are no time limits on it, and you can do it as many times as you want. So you are going to clear Part A exam definitely if you put in enough time and effort. So Part A, you can definitely clear. Even if you know high level or not, that's not an issue. Once you clear Part A exam, Part B exam unlocks, and that's a live proctored exam. This is where most of the people fail. And like I said earlier, there are mainly two reasons. One is they don't have enough time to finish the exam. The given time is 1 hour, and then you have to finish a lot of tasks under 1 hour. So a lot of people fail to finish within 1 hour. Second main reason is that they are not familiar with where all the things are. They don't have enough practice with Go HighLevel. So they kind of fumble around the software and lose time. So basically these two are interconnected. You don't know the software, or you don't know the platform well enough. So you kind of struggle to find things and you lose your time. This all comes down to the third bonus reason I gave you earlier, which is you overestimated your skill. Now, imagine you already have skill and you know how things works and everything, but you can still fail because you get overwhelmed. So there are mainly two aspects when it comes to clearing this exam in the first go. One is your mind, and second is your skill. So let's talk about the mind part first. So what happens is that when you see all these long list of instructions and the task at hand, there's a high chance that you get overwhelmed. So that happened to me as well. I got overwhelmed and looking at all the tasks that was listed in the document, and my mind kind of went blank. So this is where you have to control your nerves and get into this task. So there are so many different ways people control their nerve. If you're a meditator, maybe meditate before the exam or some things like that. Maybe take a couple of deep breaths and all that. But ultimately it all comes down to your knowledge and expertise. So if you really know the platform inside out, you don't really need to calm your nerves. I'm pretty sure though you would be stressed in the beginning, but after a few minutes you would be running through each and every items in the list and finishing one by one. So my suggestion would be to learn by doing, build a business, and maybe a mock business, maybe onboard someone. So try a practice onboarding of a potential client or an imaginary client and run through the whole process at least once. I have done multiple times before my exam. I have created one sub account. I've done the setup for that account for it to be up and running. Then I would go to my agency account, and then I would run through all the steps that I need to go through. I wouldn't do it actually, but I would imagine that I would be doing. I would be clicking onto the relevant settings and all that. And then I would go to sub accounts and I would click through all the settings that I need to set up. So I have done a couple of dry runs like that. Even without creating a sub account, I would just imagine that I'm doing all this. So practice and do a couple of test runs. and get yourself really familiar with the platform. That's the only way you can clear the exam in your first go. I'm sorry to disappoint if anyone by not giving a shortcut for one answer, and I can only tell you this much without breaking the integrity of this exam. So it all comes down to two things basically: relax your nerves and practice, practice, practice. If you get these two things right, you can finish this Part B exam on your first go under 1 hour. If you have any other questions or do you need one-on-one training, do get in touch. I'll be more than happy to help. So thank you so much. Good luck with the exams. I'll see you in the next one.